today we are going to start about the control points. You know, in conventional asphalt mix design, when we were developing by using the Marshall method, there was limit defined known as the upper limit and the lower limit. But in the Superpave specification, it's not like this. Because Superpave specification is going to depend upon the nominal maximum size of the aggregate. So here in the Superpave, the control points are established and those control points are going to serve the purpose for the control of the coarse aggregate, for the control of the fine aggregate and for the control of the filler. Because some limit is defined, some points are given and our blended curve should pass through those points. So these points are very, very critical. So that's why we can define it, the gradation control points are very important part of Superpave Mix Design. Clear it? Now, if it is said, these are very, very important part. Before I define their limit, so keep this in mind that these control points act as a master curve. Through which gradation must pass. After writing this definition, now we have to explain what are those control points. So these control points depends upon four numbers. Number one, maximum size of the aggregate. First point is placed as a point. Nominal maximum size of aggregate. Intermediate sieve. This is taken as 2.36 mm sieve number. Last one, smallest sieves. Means 0.075. Now the question arises, although we have defined maximum size of the aggregate, nominal maximum size of the aggregate, intermediate sieve and smallest sieve, and where we have to place those points and what should be the limit. So before I start defining the limit, I would like to tell you that limits of these points, mean the span between these two points, depends upon the nominal maximum aggregate size. So that's why we can write down for easiest way that the limits varies with respect to
nominal maximum aggregate size. Now, as throughout our lecture, we are saying that our requirement is asphalt concrete bearing course. This is our requirement, asphalt concrete bearing course. Let me just color it for that. I am going to highlight this one, asphalt concrete bearing course. For this asphalt bearing course, nominal maximum aggregate size is taken 2.5 mm, which we have defined it many times. Now for this point, as if 12.5 is our nominal, then our maximum aggregate size MAS is 19 mm. Now we will define the limit. That what should be the limit? So its answer is, because it is only defined in the four seams, MAS is a 19, NMAS is a 12.5, 2.36, 0.075. These are the seams. Now over here we will define the limit. Limit means minimum value and then maximum value. Clear it? Minimum value and maximum value. Over here, 100% material should pass. For the nominal maximum size of the aggregate, we have the limit minimum 90, maximum 100. For this intermediate seam, we have this value 28% up to 58%. For this smallest seam, we have the value 2 and 10. So keep this thing in mind. Whatever the values I have written over here, this is the seam size. Whatever the values I have written over here, it is for this nominal maximum aggregate size. But you know, when we are going to make the mix design for the bearing for the base course, maybe 19 mm will be your NMAS. So this I have written as per my own requirement. If you as a designing engineer are those who are interested to learn what are the more limit, so as I have told you, this limit varies with respect to nominal maximum aggregate size. So you people are requested to see the specification table for the Superpave Mix Design. So this I have only converged my discussion only up to this point. If some other, we have the nominal maximum size of the aggregate, this limit which I have defined over here, it will vary. So this was my just small video in order to dictate about you this nominal maximum size of the aggregate. Now I will show you in the graph that where are these after giving you this brief description. As I have already explained in my previous videos, that is our maximum density line. Let me draw my maximum density line like this one. It is MDL, maximum density line. So this point is MES and this point NMAS, and over here DI raised power 0.45. Here as usual 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 and 100. This is our capital P, passing percentage. on this graph which I have shown over here, and whatever the values I have already explained to you, for the maximum size of the aggregate it is 100%. Then for the nominal maximum size of the aggregate it is 100, and then 90%. These are 2 points. Then we come to the intermediacy, it is 58, and then it is 28. These are the point of representation. Now further, the smallest seams, it is 2 and 10. So these points are known as my CP. And this curve which I have shown over here, this is a maximum density line. Maximum density line in MDN. So this curve will be showing like this one. When I say that, whenever we have the gradation done, as I have already explained to you, the gradation curve should pass between these 2 points. So it means it should be like this one. This is just for your understanding, that the master curve, these the points are going to act as master curve, and our blended aggregate gradation should pass between these 2 points. Just for your understanding, I have drawn this line. And next, whenever we will make the blend of aggregate, there I will show you again that how our combined aggregate gradation will lying is going to pass through these points. So this is a just brief introduction. Thank you very much for seeing this.